rock and roll. HairCor!
And more.
Good morning, Harry.
Good morning, Corey.
You know, I like our theme more than probably any other theme in the world.
It's pretty good.
I
like it too.
You've got a better memory about stuff than I do.
Okay.
I don't know if you know that.
Specific things, maybe.
Well, you know, you remind me of things. Like, I don't remember things the way that you remember them. Like, I can remember them when I'm sort of jarred into remembering it. But I don't, like, naturally sit around and remember stuff like you do.
Really? I think it's good practice.
I don't work the brain like you do, I guess.
Well, mine's a little slower than everyone else's, so you gotta keep practicing.
Remind me exactly, there are elements to that theme song that we recorded, what, like 12 or 15 years ago?
Mm-hmm.
That I'm not sure I remember all the elements. It was maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago that we were doing a show and you reminded me that that sound is a shovel.
Yes.
It's a snow shovel that we're hitting.
No, it was a regular round mouth.
Like a spade.
Yeah, it was a regular round mouth because you can't get that sound out of a snow shovel.
Oh, I didn't mean like a plastic snow shovel. I thought it was maybe one of those aluminum snow shovels you keep in your trunk.
I have an aluminum snow shovel, and if I wang it, it's not going to sound like that. For a fact that's a round mouth.
Did we hit it with a drumstick? Was that it, maybe?
I'd imagine so, but it doesn't sound like a stick. It sounds like something, like probably my knuckle.
You think so?
Yeah, if I had to guess by the timbre of it, I'd say it was my knuckle.
Timbre. I like how you pronounce that correctly. Most people don't. Most people say timber.
Yeah.
Good for you.
No, I like timbre.
Well, that's what that's how you say it. You're an audio engineer, you can tell.
That's right. Yeah, and some of the other sounds I made with my mouth. Mm-hmm. I think there's a majority of them I made with my mouth. I think you gave me the opportunity to catalog a few of my noises, I think as a result, you had a little bit of fun when I wasn't around and put that together.
Well, I do recall, like when you listen to the very end, there's me gagging and laughing.
Yeah.
I'm not sure exactly. Is that me or you?
That's me.
Do it.
Okay. Hello?
Hi.
How are you?
Hello.
Oh, hello.
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 Hi.
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 How are you?
Jesus. It's like a repeat of last episode.
Why does your sister always know that we're taping?
I don't know. Maybe she's following us on Facebook and stalking us.
Do you just hang up the phone when you see fit?
All right.
Because I noticed you don't say goodbye. I think you just kind of hang up.
Yeah. Well, it's obviously not for me.
While I'm gagging at the end of that and laughing, I think what I'm hearing, this is what I'm getting back to, is your good memory. Were we not pouring water from one cup into another?
We also had like a mop bucket that we had water in too.
Oh yes, and we were pouring water like into the mop bucket.
Yes,
because it sounds like I'm laughing and gagging and peeing at the end.
Yes. Well, I think that was kind of how we kind of looked at it. Like, it sounds like you're laughing and pissing at the same time.
Right. But now the vocal work that we did on that was originally from the first pilot episode that we did way back in that studio.
And, absolutely.
And it wasn't like we came up with theme ideas during the show and we sang that intro, right?
Yes. And then edited it together later.
Now, to be fair, we got to say we're sick. We're still two sick people. We sound sick. We can't get our heads straight. It's brutal.
I apologize. I think we jinxed ourselves with our title of our last episode, Worst Christmas, and I think I drove myself to have the worst Christmas ever.
We set that target and we hit it.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't see you at all. I came all the way home and I didn't see you once. That sucks.
Well, I didn't leave the house for almost 2 weeks.
Except to go to like Emerge.
No, I was not good.
Yeah.
I did leave the house once, but that was to go visit the hospital on telehealth notice. They wanted to call me in an ambulance, for Christ's sakes.
To go to at your house? Take you over there?
Yeah.
Really?
Yep. Like, sir, you shouldn't be driving if you're blacking out. I'm like, I'm not going to drive. I'll get somebody to drive for me.
That is a good rule of thumb. Ambulance.
Pardon?
That is a good rule. When you're blacking out, don't drive.
Yes.
Yep. They should have a ride program for that. Son, have you been blacking out tonight? It's like, yep.
Don't make me laugh. I still hurt.
Yeah, you know what? I can't laugh or make a lot of noise without coughing still. I've got just a little bit of like the lingering phlegm in my lungs.
Mm-hmm.
I could feel it immediately when I went to Houston. And as soon as I got off the plane, I just felt, uh-oh. You know where you got that feeling and that taste and that sensation in your core? That it's like, ooh, there's something coming up. And that was it. Boom. I've got this cold and I'm sick. And then the next thing you know, I forgot when I went to see all the nieces and nephews, how kids are basically sacks of disease.
Oh my God. I know.
That's all they are transmitters of virus. They're coughing and blowing and puking and hacking. It's brutal.
Yep. And then our population puts them all together for 5 days a week.
Well, let's throw them in daycare. It's like, and then you can
school.
Whatever your kid went to school with is going to leave it there and come back with something even better. You know, it's just...
Oh, yeah. Maybe two or three.
I'm starting to think that either I'm not going to have any kids or I'm going to have a kid and I'm going to keep it isolated until it gets a job. You know?
It's harder than you think.
It is. I guess going back to the thing with the theme, because I don't know why I was thinking about that today again. But okay. We should probably let people who are listening to the show now for the first time and are joining the podcast.
Yes.
Know that if you really, 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 really want to know where this all started, you can go back to that website, haircoreandthemore.com.
That's right.
And you can find an episode that we call The Origin, right?
Yep.
And on The Origin is you and I coming up with the theme.
Yep.
I can't remember, though, because this is where your great super memory comes in. Who played guitar on that?
That's a good question. I was playing a lot of guitar at that time in your studio because if I'm correct, you had the what was that? Is it a Roland guitar synth?
Yeah,
is that true?
Yes, I did have a guitar synth. Correct.
So I was playing with that thing a lot, and we did a lot of material with me on guitar. Now I can't. My memory doesn't serve whether that was me or not on the theme.
It doesn't sound like I played it. That's what I'm getting at.
I'm not sure if I played it either, because I don't remember it.
It sounds like if I were to play it, like I played it funnily, like I played it with my other hand or something. Like I didn't really mean to play it like that.
Here, Corey, turn this upside down and now play.
Yeah, exactly. Because if, you know, looking at that line and its simplicity, I would never have executed that riff that way. Never.
I wouldn't put it past us to do something like that either.
Yeah.
Flip your guitar up. But I don't know. It could have been me. I should listen to it again. Because that the guitar part is buried for me, and I'm listening to a bunch of other stuff.
Well, why don't we make a promise to each other at the end of this episode? Because we replay the theme as an outro. Let's listen to it together.
Yeah. All right.
And we'll talk about it and we'll analyze it. It'd be fun.
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right. I got topics. I don't know if you got topics tonight.
I've got a couple.
Yeah. You've got like old topics in the steel book, or have you got like new topics that we haven't gotten to? Because I think I overtalked last week.
I've got some of each.
I like each. We could... Oh, no, you got to play your tune.
I got to play my tune.
Set it up right now.
All right. This is the Mumford & Sons with Broken Crown and I Will Wait.
Touch my mouth and hold my tongue. I'll never be your chosen one. I'll be home, safe and tucked away. Well, you can't tempt me if I don't see the day. The pull on my flesh was just too strong, stifled the choice and the air in my lungs. Better not to breathe in lot. 'Cause when I open my body, I breathe the light. Take the road, and I can fuck it all away. But in this twilight, our choices seal our fate.
Back to back.
What the fuck?
And I fell heavy into your arms. These days of darkness, which we've known, will blow away with this new sun. But I for you forgave, and I won't forget. Know what we've seen, and him at last. Now in some way, shape the excess. Well, as strong, and use my head alongside my heart, so tame my flesh and fix my eyes, a tethered mind freed from the lies.
Sipping your cup of Joe. It's another typical morning, but something is different. You hear a sound unlike one you've ever heard before. You realize that you may have stumbled upon the greatest audio discovery since the dawn of mankind. You realize that you're in.
HairCor!
In the morning.
Hello? Are you there?
I have a confession.
Uh-oh.
No, it's not a bad thing.
Oh.
That was the first time that I've ever listened to Mumford & Sons.
Really?
Yeah, you know, and I didn't mean to say boo on your Facebook, but what I was trying to say is that I had probably the best non-listening to Mumford & Sons streak going on Earth.
For a guy who has a independent music show, you'd think you would have listened to some of it by now.
That's my point. That's my whole point, is that I went for so long without ever hearing a single note out of that band. I went out of my way to make sure none of that ever entered my ear canal.
Why?
Because that was...
I can't find where you're getting your disdain from.
It's not disdain. There are a handful of things that define me as cool. Now I don't have that one.
Hmm?
No, the point is, you know, but it was like 5 or 6 years ago, a buddy of mine who's like, you don't know Mumford & Sons and you listen to independent music? It's like, You know what I hate? Okay, let me backtrack a little bit.
Okay.
I really, really dislike when people find out that you have a music show on the internet. And then they come up to you and then they say things like, how could you not know this band? Drives me nuts. You know, there's a million bands in just the U.S. alone. And people are like, you listen to independent music and you don't know these guys? So I got one of those where the CD was put in front of me at a bar and said, how do you like this CD? I said, I haven't heard it. They said, what? You're supposed to be a radio guy.
Fair enough. I understand that. It's like being a DJ at any kind of gig and having someone come up and tell you, can you play, that song? What the hell song was that?
Yeah, that one.
How come you don't have that one?
I liked a lot of that. I don't know. I think the banjo was a bit much. I liked how the banjo was incorporated in the first tune, but the second tune, it's like, all right, I kind of get it. You got a banjo. All right.
Yeah. All right. Oh, I find it really fresh. It's coming out of left field for me, and I needed something new, and I don't know. I can relate to it right now.
Here's what I don't like about the British. Is that they take a perfectly good chorus, and they do it 50 times. As an outro. And it's like, to stop. I get it. It's a great chorus. It's catchy. Nice hook. Stop. Because the British will just sit there on and on and on. And it's just like, do it live. Do it live where we got the lighters and we're all at Wembley Stadium and yada, yada, yada. But I mean, for crying out loud, when you do the records, just stop with the chorus. That's what I hate about the British. So... I'm sure I'm going to get an email about
ta-da.
That. Ta-da! Temperance.
Ay, ay, ay.
Should I go through my topics list, or do you want to pull one of yours?
No, you go ahead.
All right, let me see what I got here.
I'm hoping to segue into mine, if I can find a spot.
You know, I got an iPad mini, and I want like a second one already.
I bet.
Yeah, these things are great. Okay, I know you don't subscribe to this, and we talked to about it a little bit before the break, but... New Year's resolutions, dude.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
By the way, Chad Hayes from Fun Radio Louisiana says, you're an independent radio guy and you haven't heard of Mumford & Sons? I should always turn my Skype off.
That's too good.
Do you have any New Year's resolutions? I mean, for real, like even a secret one that you're not telling anybody that you might want to tell everybody?
Well, hang me out to dry, why don't you, Corey?
You've got one, don't you? You got one. You got a little one.
Yeah, maybe. I'm not going to atone it to, I can't relate it to New Year's. It's been something that's been looming in the shadows for a little while now. And being that sick over the holidays and having the pain that I went through just... you know, kind of confirm that I should really get off my duff and at least start walking for now.
Oh, you're just going to get, you're not going to say, look, I'm going to be health guy. What you're saying is I'm just going to get more active.
Yes.
Oh, that's a good resolution. That's not a resolution, I guess, but it sort of is. Everybody's got a wee resolution, just a wee one.
I can't believe you had me say that.
I went for a run today. Ugh.
Did you?
Yeah. Ugh. First one of the year. First one in a while. Not fun. Not fun at all.
No.
Oh, my God. Turns out I'm way out of shape now.
Welcome to my world.
I mean, yeah, and it sucks. Really, really does. Should we do a segment?
Sure, let's do a segment.
All right, let me see if I can find what my little segment. Oh, I got one here for you. It's going to be a good one.
Okay.
Let's cue this up.
I got a favor to ask.
Okay, ask your favor. After I set up this tune, we're going to play a little bit of HairCor in the morgue. Guess the tune. One of my favorite games in all of the world, where I'm going to read the lyrics of a song over the internet to Harry, and Harry's going to guess the name of the song.
Okay. If you're going to play Gregerson's Read the Lyrics, you have to have your finger on the pause button for me.
Okay, I'm not... Gregerson's got nothing to do with this. It's just, okay. It's all me.
But I'm just saying.
Okay. Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
When the night falls, the big moon's gonna rise. You can look right up, see it in the sky. It makes me feel like I'm going to blow a fuse. I start to shiver and shake with a strange kind of blues. But I like it. I see it now. The moon is high above. It's got a hold of me. I just can't get enough. Big, round, black and white. I feel the pull. I see the light. big bad moon's looking down on me tonight. But I like it. When the moon comes...
Bad moon rising?
No.
Okay, keep going.
When the moon comes, got nowhere to hide. It can turn your head around like it turns the tide.
Jesus.
Man, woman, boy, child, makes you feel like you were born wild. The big bad moon's looking down on me tonight. But I like it. I like it. Talking about big bad moon. Oh yeah, big bad moon. Talking Jesus. About big bad moon. Oh yeah.
Oh my God.
That's it.
I haven't a clue.
That was Big Bad Moon by Joe Satriani.
I never would have known that.
Really?
No.
You wouldn't. You've never heard that tune?
What album is it off?
A Flying in a Blue Dream, but it's the one tune that he sang, and he had the big video on MTV.
I didn't have MTV.
Oh. Oh no, and you didn't have any Satriani.
No,
I feel bad.
No,
now I cheated on that one. I'm sorry.
Well, that's I didn't cheat. You didn't know. It's all right.
Well, I figured you'd have that record.
Jeez. No, I don't have any Satch.
None. You don't have even Surfing with the Alien.
Nope.
Really?
I've heard Surfing, but I don't have it. No.
Wow.
Yeah, I know.
I hope none of that shows up in your Dropbox, because that would be wrong. Anyway, that's a pretty funny Satriani tune, because he plays the harmonica and he sings, and it's sort of like it's a boogie, and all the listeners to the podcast.
Jesus.
I feel like you're mad at me. Are you mad at me?
I'm not. Oh no, don't. I'm sorry. I'm trying not to laugh. It might be my drugs. They've made me really moody.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've been taking it out on a lot of people this week, I think. Really sharp.
You know, I'm going to say something. I sensed that today when we started. We were doing a little preamble. You know how we like to warm up with a nice coffee before we start work?
Yeah.
And I was sensing that there's something inside of you that's foreign.
Just had a really bad holiday, I guess, you know.
Was there something that didn't meet your expectations? Were you hoping to get something for Christmas and you didn't?
No, that was cool. I got a wicked set of binoculars. I didn't get to do anything, you know.
Yeah, I didn't see you. We didn't party. So I mean, you can't cling to that though. You got to let it go, right?
No, I'm not. I know. And at the same time, I'm still not feeling 100%. And I apologize. I apologize to everybody. I'm trying not to laugh so I don't go into another fit, right? So I guess I don't know. I'm putting up some sort of barrier so I don't let myself laugh by being constantly in a perturbed state. Does that make sense?
It does make sense. And you know what's funny is that knowing now that I can't make you laugh kind of adds an extra layer of fun to this show.
So yeah, now you're going to try and make
No, I'm not going to try and make you laugh. I'm not going to try and make you. I won't be funny at all. I swear to God. I swear. I won't be funny. All right.
Okay.
All right. You know, I got that little cough still too. I'm trying to figure out here. You know, we talked about resolutions. We're not going to do them, but I kind of need to get back on track or back on path, as they say, man.
You had this whole thing of enlightenment and you did yoga and you meditated and you blogged and you ran every day, right?
Yep. And now look at me.
You turned into an armchair warrior.
Yeah, I'm one step away from being a hobo, basically. I sit around. No, in all fairness, prior to Christmas, this is my case. As soon as I moved out here to the damn beach, all I did was eat, drink, and screw, and do radio. I mean, that's pretty much my whole life.
Do you know what's funny? People like your magical thinking and your resolutions and everything. It falls along the lines of praying, right?
Yeah.
It's funny how people pray till they get what they want, and then once they got it, they stop praying.
That's the secret. Yeah, you get what you want, and it's like, oh, I'm ran out of stuff that I care about. I kind of got everything I need now. I don't think it's that. I mean, that's somebody actually sent me an email and said that's what it is, but it's not that at all. I just, you know what? I haven't been, I just been completely disconnected. I've been unhooked from where I was going and what got me to where I am.
You had a big move. You changed careers. You moved locations. You've got all these new sets of distractions. What the hell do you expect?
Yeah. So I went running, and I started eating better. And instead of drinking 11 of these beers, I've only got 3. So that's a start.
Speaking of drinks, I had all this time to myself. I've came up with a new Caesar for you. I want to share with you when I come down there.
I want to tell you about a Caesar too.
Sweet.
Okay.
Well, anyway, let me finish.
Okay.
I've got two names for it that I'm deciding between. Either Harry's the Beef Eater, or Harry's Smoke, or Harry's Smoke Caesar.
Go on. What does this involve? Let's do it now. We'll do your segment after the Caesars.
Okay. Well, I'm not going to give away the recipes at this point. I want to share it with you before I do.
Okay.
But yeah, I'm having trouble deciding between the two names. At the same time, I can use the previous one for another Caesar that I do have a whole different recipe. So
now, for the people who are listening in the United States right now, who don't know what the frick a Caesar is, it's not really, it's a Bloody Mary basically with Clamato juice is the first way that you look at it, right? It's not tomato, it's Clamato.
Yeah, normally the basic ingredients is you got a dash of Tabasco, a couple of dashes of Worcestershire, and then maybe some lemon or lime juice, rim the glass with celery salt, garnish with celery salt. Celery or a pickle or a lemon wedge.
Oh my God. That sounds so delicious right now. You know, I got back into Caesars in the morning when I was home. Do Americans even know what Clamato is? Do they have that? Do they have clam juice down there?
I'm not sure. I can't see why not. Like, you look at New Orleans, right? They're king of the crawfish and whatnot. They got to know what a Caesar is.
I'm sure they do. Okay, now my brother made me a Caesar, and there were two things that I thought were pretty spectacular about it. One, he took the, Chroma Critter says that Americans have clam juice. Thank you, chat. It turns out that the best way to make a Caesar is to take the vodka 3 or 4 days in advance, and you saturate it with cucumber.
Oh.
Yeah. You with me so far?
Yeah.
And then there was something where there were these beans, like these, they were called meanie beanies, I think. It was like a jar of pickled beans. And instead of a celery stick, it's like a spicy garlic pickled bean that you put in it.
Oh, it's a green bean, like a long string bean style?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that before.
Good.
I'm not a fan morning. Of those Caesars myself.
You want to do your segment?
They're okay. I guess we could.
Meow. It's time for another episode from your favorite guys at
HairCor in the Mall presents.
It's time for the queen, not so queen, to read some Zed Leppelin lyrics for you and Corey.
Did he say Zed Leppelin?
Corey asked to guess which track the queen is reading to him.
Oh, she's going to go to hell.
Anyways, it's time to get on with it. Let's hear
it.
You're going to do it all right.
I don't care what you say.
Yeah, get over here right now. No, get over here.
No.
Do it.
I told you, go away.
If you don't, I'll.
Out of here.
Get over here and do this.
You guys are weird.
You're weird, you bitty old bit.
I don't know what I'm doing.
You said it.
I'm not going to comment on that anymore.
I've been down since I began to crawl. If it wasn't for bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all.
Oh, God. 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 Stop. Start again. No, don't start again. Start from there. I got it. Sorry. Go on.
Bad luck and trouble's my only friend. I've been down ever since I was 10.
What?
I've been down since I began to crawl. If it wasn't for bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all. You know, wine and women is all I crave. A big bad woman's gonna carry me to the grave.
This isn't the Stones, right? I know it's not the Stones.
Nope.
No.
Oh, I've been down since I began to crawl.
God, it keeps going. It just keeps telling me that.
If it wasn't for bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all.
The queen is sick.
Yeah. Excuse me.
It sounds like E.T.
Oats.
Don't laugh.
Bad luck and troubles being my only friend. I've been down ever since I was 10. I've been down since I began to crawl. If it wasn't for bad luck, I'd have no luck at all. If it wasn't for real bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all.
So we have to stop. We have to stop. We have to. We have to, because I get it, but I don't get it.
Born under a bad sign.
Oh, God. By who?
Born under a bad sign.
By who? Who did this?
Cream. Cream.
You're kidding.
Yes, sir. You know that song,
yes,
right?
Yes. Wow. Okay. God, that made me mad inside, but also hurt. Because I had a burp laugh. You know when you burp laugh?
Yeah.
Like you're burping and then you're going to laugh. You can't laugh because you're sick. It sucks for you.
Yeah, well, because then you get everything all over your microphone.
Yeah, exactly. God, that was just so sad. Let's play a tune. That just makes me sad. Okay?
Sorry.
This is one of my favorite Led Zeppelin tunes off one of my favorite Led Zeppelin records. It's one of the records that pretty much everybody hates and pretty much I love. And I think you're with me, right?
Me too.
In Through the Outdoor. Oh, my God. Carousel Alhambra.
We'll be right back.
What do you get when you combine two Canadians, two microphones, a 5,000-watt transmitter, and great music? You get...
HairCor!
And more.
We got a ton of people on the internet jumping all over the fact that we played that cut.
Really?
You know who was listening? Actually, was at FM 92.7, I think. There's a whole radio station in Louisiana who was listening to us do that because they dig that tune. we're popular.
Good song.
Yes. My favorite record. Oh. You know what? When my brother bought that record and he took it, he brought it home, and I guess that was maybe like in what? Oh God, 80 what? So.
Oh, I was gonna say 79, but
yeah. Let me see here. Let me pull it up on the thing here. Oh, there it is right there. Okay, In Through the Outdoor. Oh my God. It was recorded over a three-week period between November and December 1978, came out in 1979. I was four.
Mm-hmm.
Such a groundbreaking record. They weren't afraid to get the synths out, get the Moog, and just do it. And for me, when my brother brought that record home and he dropped that needle on the very beginning cut, you know, in the evening.
Yep.
Where they've got all that great trippy synth stuff going. I just kind of want to play it right now. And then he just like plant from the background through the echoes, like in the evening. And it's just, I know, God. It's just for me, that was kind of like it busted my rock and roll cherry.
I guess so. It was my rock and roll cherry.
Mm-hmm.
My XXX was a big fan, and I used to go through her catalog, and man, great stuff to have a bath and a bottle of wine with.
you count X's like that? Do you really do that?
Yeah, I do. It's easier to keep track.
Where the checks have to go?
What?
Where all the checks have to go?
Yeah.
You know who I think is listening as well is Chad. Like we mentioned Chad. I can't remember which one of the Duck Dynasty people he is, though. I think it's Cousin Chad. Have you seen this Duck Dynasty thing?
Damn. Actually, I have not seen it. I've heard it's kind of the thing. But I do have a friend on Facebook who's friends with one of the guys. Yeah. And she goes hunting for squirrel and muskrat and stuff with them all the time. She's got a pink real leaf shotgun. It's kind of sexy.
Off the air, I'll tell you a Duck Dynasty story that's pretty interesting. It involves a Duck Dynasty guy and a pregnant woman.
Excellent. Yeah, it's pretty, sounds good to me.
Pretty whatever. Look, I'm looking here at my list of things to talk about in the last 9 minutes, and none of them are good.
Oh, okay. Well, I was going to recap our last show. We were talking about accents and whatnot and how it's so hard to turn off the Queen after you've been doing it, right?
But that's a whole other thing, how hard it is to turn off the Queen. Don't laugh.
But I remembered the Aussie saying that a guy I used to work with used to say to everybody all the time. And I it took me forever to figure it out. But now that I got it, you know, you'll probably get it right away. Out of the way, Dopey!
What?
Did you get that?
No.
Out of the way, Dopey! He used to say that all day long.
Who used to say it all day long?
This guy used to work with a Canadian Tire in the warehouse.
That you used to work with?
Yes.
At Canadian Tire?
Yes.
When did you work at Canadian Tire? I didn't even know you worked at Canadian Tire.
I built the new store and then I shipped all the... I was in charge of running all the old product from the old store to the new store. And then I was in housewares selling electronics for
Do they even sell tires?
Pardon?
Do they even sell tires at Canadian Tire anymore?
Yeah, and they're too expensive, and they don't fit my car. That's another story. But, what would happen, though, is I lost the job because, first off, I didn't like it. And second off, the district manager or what do you call him, the dealer, the guy that owned the place, I guess he was looking for me all the time. He could never find me. I was out in the parking lot all the time installing car stereos and helping people out with their cars out in the parking lot, and I guess I wasn't supposed to do that.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like your job.
Well, I could do it. So I figured, you know, a happy customer is a repeat customer.
Did I promise to work over the holiday season on an accent? I think I said I was going to do that.
Well,
does that ring a bell?
I'm not gonna hold you to it.
Yeah, but you listen to the show. I don't listen to the show. So if I said I was gonna do something, like, you gotta let me know.
You don't listen to anything.
I don't. I don't have time.
Nope. Don't. Too busy doing.
Too busy doing. Can't be not doing. Okay, well let me why don't you throw an accent at me? Give me like a give me a nationality. And I'll just see if I can produce it.
All right. Okay. Would like to hear your. Let's see. Oh, I remember what I told you. I wanted to hear a Mexican Canadian. Oh God.
Mexican Canadian. It's a Mexican.
Mexican.
Mexican. All right.
Canjin.
All right, but is it like a Mexican French Canadian, or is it a Mexican Canadian from out east, or is it a Mexican Canadian from like southwestern Ontario? Give me a Canadian region first before I incorporate the Mexican region.
How about Saskatoon, eh?
Saskatoon. Okay, Saskatoon Mexican Canadian. All right. What is he going to do? I got to have something actually he's going to say here. So let me go on the internet. I'm just going to read the Wikipedia page that I've got in front of me for
say this. Today was tomorrow yesterday.
No, I got this in front of me. I got the Wikipedia article for Led Zeppelin's In Through the Outdoor. Okay, so this is my first. So this might be a new segment here that we're doing. This is me doing a Mexican Canadian of descent from a Saskatoon mayor and a Mexican bull. In Through the Outdoor is the 8th studio album in the English rock band Led Zeppelin. Wait a minute. Can I start again? Is there a way I can start again? I think there is, right? I think I could start again. It's cool. All right, let's do this. I'm going to start again. Okay, Mexican, Canadian, Saskatoon. Don't laugh. What threw me off is that I knew that you were on the other end of the line. Listening.
I'll mute myself.
Okay. Everybody who's listening right now, don't listen because you're making me nervous. Okay. In Through the Outdoor is the 8th studio album by English rock band Led Zeppelin. Sounds like Lars Ulrich from Metallica. Is it possible that every time I do an accent, it might come out sounding like Lars? I like this segment. We're going to do this every week. I might have to go ahead and put together a little bit of a stinger for that.
Oh, my God. I got a stinger. I can use a stinger. I'm putting together an idea for a new stinger. I'll try and tone it that direction, okay?
Okay.
I have another idea for another segment too.
Oh, go for it.
You know,
it's
the
new year. We need new stuff, right?
we also were talking last week about my worst Christmas present. I thought, why don't we start a new segment? The coolest / shittiest of anything. Like, for example, board games. So the coolest board game there is, or the shittiest board game, or the shittiest contact sport.
I like this. I like this. Yeah. Yeah. So is the idea that we throw the topic at each other during the week, and then we surprise each other during the week who thinks they've got the best and the shittiest?
We could do that. We could do that, or we could put it to our listeners since we have 1-800 number too.
We should. We got to talk about that too, if you don't mind.
I don't.
Okay. Because, everybody's bugging me on Skype because I'm not in the chat room. And we need to do a little bit more of an interactive show, I think, going forward. We can use the toll-free line. If you want to call it right now, I'll watch it. It's 888-741-7472. If you call that number toll-free anywhere in Canada, the U.S., that thing will ring. But I got to patch that through to this desk. So it'll just be me going over to that phone and talking to you. So that's what you want to do. And please don't do it during the day because I'm working.
So, I thought you patched it.
I didn't patch it. No, I went for vacation. Don't you remember? Okay, so then.
Oh, yeah.
And number two, when we started the chat room on the website, you know, nobody went in the chat room. Nobody was there. It was just you and me, and we weren't chatting with each other. Yep. We just chat on Skype.
Yeah.
So what do you think I should do? Do you think I should actually start a... Like, do you think I should really get, like, what do I do?
I don't know. You're blindsiding me here. I don't know either. Like, the chat room sucks balls anyways. It's hard to use.
It does suck balls. You should take it off.
Monkeys with my display.
Do we really want to interact with these people?
Some of them. I like what Chad had to say.
Yeah, and I'm talking to Chroma Critter right now, and she's pretty cool too. She's got a lot of cool stuff to say, so that's nice.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's cool. I appreciate. It's nice to have feedback, right?
Mostly, she says that my accent was pretty shit. So, I think I nailed Lars Ulrich though at the end.
It made me laugh. So, I haven't laughed like that since before the holidays. Damn, I missed you.
I know, man. I missed you too. Yeah. Do you want an internet hug?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's so nice.
You feel warm.
Okay, not too long.
Yeah, it just gets a little gay after a bit.
Don't look at me like that in the camera.
All right. I guess what I'm going to try and do here is postulate here on how to interact with the audience more if we want to, you know, because I feel like what's happening this year, this show is going to take off. This is the year of HairCor, you know.
We've worked out the kinks, and it's time to, not so much get a little more serious, but, you know, try some things out, do some fresh stuff, right?
I think that's a good idea. Okay. Well, I've only got one more thing to say.
Yes.
Good morning, Harry. Good morning, Harry.
HairCor!